Hello and welcome. In a previous tutorial, we got to know the basic workflow when applying shape-based matching in MVTec HALCON. In this tutorial, we will go into more detail about how shape-based matching works and how to speed up your matching algorithms. Additionally, we will take a look at some advanced search parameters. These might help if your application doesn't find all matches, for example, because they are blurred or deformed. First, let's take a look at a basic functionality of shape-based matching called pyramid levels. Internally, shape-based matching works with image pyramids. This means that the size of both the image and the model are reduced iteratively. The search for matches is first performed in the low-resolution image, which is very fast. Based on the result, the search area is limited in the following pyramid level. Thus, the model doesn't have to be searched in the complete image. This saves time while preserving accuracy. Let's create a new model and double-click the handle here to have a look at the model parameters. Initially, the number of pyramid levels is set to auto. When training the model based on a template image or XLD, the number of pyramid levels is estimated. Using the operator inspect shape model, you can get a good impression of the pyramid levels. If NumLevels is set to high, some matches may be lost because they may not be recognized in a low-resolution image. On the other hand, if you begin the search on a lower pyramid level, it may take a long time because of the high resolution. It can happen that the training step estimates the number of pyramid levels too high. This results in an unsuccessful or unrobust search. To fix this, you can limit the pyramid levels during the search. Note that you can also skip lower levels in the search by specifying a lowest pyramid level. This helps to improve the runtime of your application. The accuracy, however, decreases because you're working with only half the possible resolution. Now, the search here begins in the third pyramid level and ends in the second level. The pyramid levels are also useful in high noise situations. Here, we want to detect the circlips in a very noisy image. Therefore, we use a noisy sample image showing the model and background to estimate a suitable lowest pyramid level. Thus, all matches in the search image are found. Sometimes, images may also be blurred. Consequently, your matches might not be found at the lowest pyramid level because the edges are not clear enough. Nevertheless, the edges may appear sharper on higher pyramid levels because the transition from bright to dark takes fewer pixels. In this case, we can set pyramid level robust tracking to true. Now, if no instance of the model can be found on the lowest pyramid level, HALCON determines the last pyramid level on which at least one instance of the model could be found. Thus, matches which are blurred can be found. If shape-based matching doesn't find all matches, one reason might be that the objects are deformed, like these paper clips. Using the parameter max deformation, you can specify how much a match might be deformed in pixels. This can be powerful, but it increases runtime. A high value can also lead to false matches, as seen here. To fix this, we can, for example, limit the maximum number of matches. Note that this limit is generally applied to every pyramid level, so this may lead to missing matches. Another approach to get the desired result here is to increase the minimum score. The score represents how much of the model is visible in the search image. It is a number between 0 and 1. For example, here, we hide half the object in the search image. The resulting score is about 0.5. The score is returned for every match in the match result handle. It can be queried with Get Generic Shape Model Result. As we have seen before, you can influence the search process by setting a minimum score. Like the minimum number of matches, the minimum score is used as a filter on every pyramid level. Therefore, the minimum score usually must be a bit lower than the final result score. Increasing the minimum score is an effective way to speed up the search and get rid of false matches. In many applications, you might consider using an image with a reduced domain as the input image for the search. For example, here we have an object with an irregular background. We're trying to find this cross. When running Find Generic Shape Model as usual, we notice that it takes a long time to run. This is because the size of the model is quite small in relation to the size of the image. That means that only a few pyramid levels can be used. Additionally, false matches are found. Instead of searching over the entire image, we can do a simple thresholding and then some blob analysis. From here, we can reduce the domain of the image so that we only search the part of the image where the object is located. In sum, the time required for these operations is much lower. Additionally, like in this example, you might be able to avoid false matches using this method. You may have noticed that the region of interest is very small. The matches don't have to lie completely in the region of interest. It is enough if the center of gravity of the original model is inside the region of interest. Next, let's have a look at the parameter metric. The standard value for images is use polarity. This means that if your template shows the object bright on a dark background, only objects which are bright on a dark background will be found. With ignore global polarity, you could additionally find all matches where the object is darker than the background. This has only a small impact on runtime. Finally, with ignore local polarity, it's possible to find matches where the contrast changes locally. This mode can be helpful if you're faced with illumination changes, but it increases runtime. As you see, shape-based matching is a powerful tool. There are many more parameters to fine-tune your shape matching. For example, you can specify the model orientation or the parameter greediness. If you have additional questions, have a look at HALCON's extensive documentation, including the solution guide on matching. Thank you for watching.